In the previous class, I was telling about whole numbers, and we have discussed certain properties like closure property, commutative property, associative property, and I have also told distributive property. In the distributive property, I'll be giving one of the example. Say if a whole number 5 is to be multiplied to the sum of 6 plus 3, we always multiply 5 with 6, then add 5 with 3. This becomes 30 plus 15, which is 45. Here we are distributing the multiplication, so it is called as distributive property of multiplication over addition. Multiplication over addition. In the chapters to come, you get distributive property of multiplication over subtraction is A times of B minus A times of C. This is not the only way to distribute multiplication. There is another way: A added to B then multiplied to C will be same as A times of C plus B times of C. Now I'll tell you something related to additive identity. It is the nature of zero that whenever we add a number to zero, we get the same. Whenever we add some number, say 5 is added to zero, we get 5. This is same as 0 added to 5. This is the nature of 0, that whenever 0 is added to a number, we get the same number. Some more examples are 2 plus 0 is 2, 0 plus 3 is 3, 5 plus 0 is 5. Here, 0 is called additive identity element. Similarly, there is something called as a multiplicative identity element, that is 1. Whenever a number multiplied to 1, we get the same number. 1 multiplied to that number will be the same number. If 5 has been multiplied to 1, we get 5. This is same as 1 multiplied to 5. I shall give some more example. 1 multiplied to 1 is 1, 5 multiplied to 1 is 5, 6 multiplied to 1 is 6. Here, 1 is called multiplicative identity element. Wait. Hello. You have some problem. Others are able to see. 72 participants are there. When the class is going on, please don't call. Look at multiplication by 0. Whenever 0 is multiplied to any number, we get 0 only. For example, 1 multiplied to 0 is 0, 5 multiplied to 0 is 0, 0 multiplied to 0 is 0. Any number multiplied with 0 is 0 only. Here we have few questions. These are related to operations on whole numbers. Operation refers to addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Here, there are three different numbers given. We all know how to add them, but in some arrangement, we get easier way to add these numbers or to multiply the numbers. We have to look at what rearrangement will make the things easy. Here, when I add 127 with 216, it is bit difficult. Whenever I add these two numbers together, I'll get 216 added to 784 as 1000. So 1000 on addition to 127, it is very easy and it is 1127. So here we are going to rearrange in this order so that we get 1000 plus 127, which is 1127. हम ऐसे भी ऐड कर सकते हैं, लेकिन 784 को 216 से ऐड करने से 1000 मिल जाएगा. So 1000, whenever multiples of tens are there, the addition or the multiplication becomes more easy. Now look at this particular question. We all know that 25 four times is 100. 8 times of 125 is 1000. So we get 100 times of 1000. So the result is 1 lakh. Adarsh Kumar Pandey is requesting to annotate. If that is the case, I will approve. He will only teach the next concept. Yes, Adarsh. When some teacher is teaching something, if you request for annotation, we will do the same thing, that you will only teach rest of the concepts. Adarsh, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, you please teach. Chup kyun ho yaar? Okay, I'll continue.
Sir, 1000, yes, sir.
Pardon? Just come again.
Sir, ye 1000 kaise hai, sir?
8 times of 125 is 1000, sir. Multiply karke dekho.
Okay, okay sir. Sir, now I am not able to write, so can you send this PDF in WhatsApp?
That I will see, sir. If required, I will send.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, what is the doubt?
Sir, a problem, 784 plus 127 plus 216 is there. We not addition 784 plus 127 bracket completed plus 216 plus.
Here the question is rearrange and add. So when I rearrange, I have to rearrange it in this way only. Otherwise, where is the chance to rearrange? You are telling these two should be added first. So you are not rearranging only. So you have to answer according to the question. Here the question was to rearrange and solve. So 216 when added to 784, we get 1000. Adding 1000 to 127 is easier compared to adding 784 to 127. Here you see there is distributive property to be used in solving this. We all have learned distributive property, that is A multiplied to B plus C is A times of B plus A times of C. Here, this is considered as A, this is considered as B, this is considered as A, and this is considered as C. So this can be written as A times of B plus C. B is 62, C is 38. 62 added to 38 is 100. When 100 is multiplied to 2651, we get 265100. This is the use of distributive property of multiplication over addition. The things becomes easy when you use distributive property. If you multiply these two, then add the sum with the product of these two numbers, you will take more time. The use of this particular distributive property is it will make the things easy and easily we can solve. Now look at this particular question. Here I will write where repetition is there as A, and this number as B, and this number as C. Here, I can use distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. So here, 347 is A, 163 is B, 63 is C. So A times of B minus C, which is A times of B minus A times of C. So 347 is multiplied to the difference. In the previous question, it was a sum. In this question, it is a difference. 163 minus 63 is just 100. So 100 multiplied to 347 is 34700. So it becomes very easy. If you are multiplying these two numbers, 347 multiplied to 163, you will get something. Then 343 multiplied to 63, you will get something. Then you have to find the difference. It becomes lengthier and it becomes difficult. So distributive property will help us in solving it in an easy way.
Sir, it is 347.
Which one? 347?
Previous question.
So what's the question, sir?
347. Somebody says that voice is breaking. Do you all have the same problem?
Is no, it sir. No, sir.
If the voice is breaking, the problem may be there in your network. Please see.
No, sir, it's not breaking.
Okay, sir.
Okay. No, sir.
Look at this question. Here, there is a repetition of 128. I will write A here. I'll write B here. Here, there is nothing. When nothing is there, I can write it as into 1. And I'll consider this as C. Because I have learned, or we have learned, this multiplicative identity element. When 1 is multiplied, we get the same result. Yes, most of you are giving correct answer. It is 12,800. To get that, we have to use distributive property over here. So 128 multiplied to 99 plus 1. The 99 added to 1 gives 100. So 128 into 100 is 12,800. Very good. Many have given correct answer. Here, Once again, there is a question to use distributive property. How to use distributive property for this?
Into one akobek no.
Rohit? Yes, tell
200
me.
237 into 3. 237 into 237 into 200 plus 3. 203 is 100 plus 3. 203 is written as 411.
So we are using distributive property. So when 237 is multiplied to 100 plus 237 multiplied to 3 will give 237 followed by 2 zeros plus 711. 3 times of 237 is 711. On addition, we get 24411. Now, somebody can tell, yes, Bimu can tell how to use distributive property for this.
510 bracket 90 plus 3.
90 plus
9. I'm saying, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I'm saying, sir.
Sir, 510 510
into 110 into
100
minus 1. 4,000 into 100 minus 1, sir.
50,000.
Both the ways you get the same result. You can take 90 plus 9 or 100 minus 1. We always look for an easy way. Here, multiplying with the 100 and multiplying with the 1, it's easier than multiplying with 90 or multiplying with 9. So, we will write this as 510 into 100 minus 1. And we are using A times of B minus C, which is A multiplied to B minus A multiplied to C. Therefore, we get 510 multiplied to 100 minus 510 multiplied to 1. This will be 510 followed by 2 zeros minus 510. Answer is 50490. We get this as the answer. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
I'll give one
yes, sir.
If we use this one, you get the same result.
Sir, I'm not understood, sir.
Sir,
yes, sir.
What is not understood?
Sir, we can write it as 99 into 500 plus 10. Can we write it like this, sir?
Yes, you can write it like this. 500 plus 10 multiplied to 99. We get the same result.
Yes,
this
yes,
will be
sir.
500 times of 99
yes,
plus
sir.
10 times of 99.
I multiply
yes,
it
sir.
By 99.
Yes,
yes
you get
yes,
the
sir.
Same answer.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Now, there is another question. The question here is to verify. When the question is to verify, you must remember two things, that this part is called as a left hand side part. We write it as LHS. This part is called as a right hand side part. To verify, we always show that left hand side and right hand side, they are equal to each other. Here, let me consider the left hand side. It is 537 plus 265. To find the sum, 7 added to 5 will be 12, 1 carry, 3 plus 6 is 9, 9 plus 1 is
10,
12 carry, 802.
802, sir.
When you do the same thing with the right hand side, 265 added to 537, we get the same result.
Yes,
therefore, left hand side,
that is because there are same digits, sir,
are equal. If somebody says it is,
sir, can you explain the commutative property?
Commutative property is the same. A plus B is equal to B plus A. When you rearrange and add them, the result will remain same. This property is called as commutative property.
Sir,
why is
this not
clear,
sir?
Sir, teach once again additives and arithmetic.
Why is this broken, sir?
Why is this broken? For everyone, you are not able to hear. If everybody is not able to hear, it means that there is some problem.
Yes, sir.
Karthik?
We are able to hear.
Karthik?
Yes, sir. Sir, we are able to hear.
Yes, sir.
Karthik has got some problem. Yes, Karthik? What is the doubt?
No, sir.
Don't use a funnier analytics things. You are using emoji. Unnecessary emojis.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, teach once again LHS and RHS.
Left hand side mein 537 and 265 ko add karne ke liye diya hua hai. You add them. You add them. Do you get 802?
Yes, sir.
है ना? अभी right hand side में 265 and 537 को add करने के लिए दिया हुआ है.
हाँ.
You add them, you get once again 802.
Yes, sir.
This means that the left hand side and right hand side they are equal. This
yes, sir.
This property is known as
commutative property. Right in the class box, sir.
Let me mute everyone because I need to teach. Now observe the question. The question here is 25 to be multiplied to the product 36 and 50. In the right hand side, 25 to be multiplied to 36, this product to be multiplied to 50. We use the same thing, we will consider the left hand side. The left hand side is 25 multiplied to 36 times of 50. We have learned Bodmer's rule, and whenever brackets are there, this has to be simplified first. So 36 you have to multiply with 50. So 25 into 5, 6 times is 30. 5, 3 times is 15 plus 3 is 18. We get 1800 to be multiplied to 25. So when 1800 is to be multiplied to 25, we get it as 45,000. Now look at the right hand side. In the right hand side, this 25 to be multiplied with 36, then it is to be multiplied with 50. What is the product of 25 and 36? This you need to simplify separately. We get it as 9000. This will be 9000. Multiply to 50. Once again, the result is, oh sorry, this is 900, 9000 only. 25,000. This will be 900 multiplied to 50. So here the left hand side and right hand side, they are equal to each other. So this particular part is also verified. Now we have a question. Find the least number that must be subtracted from 1000 so that 45 divides the difference exactly. This type of question you all have come across when you are preparing for your entrance examination. What is to be subtracted so that the number 45 divides 1000 exactly? Many are giving the answer as 10. We will look at why 10 to be subtracted. For that, you need to divide 1000 by 45. 1 times is 45. 5 remains here.
Sir, it goes 2 times, sir.
Correct, huh? Correct, sir.
Sir, 2 times
90, sir. 2 times 90, sir.
2 times is
10.
10.
Then what do we get? 100 10. We get?
100, sir. 100.
Yes. Once again, 2 times is 90. 10 we get. This 10 is called as a reminder.
Reminder.
So whatever reminder we get, that is to be subtracted from the given number.
Reminder.
So, sir, answer is 1035, sir.
Yes, therefore,
from the given dividend,
the least number to be subtracted.
990.
No, sir. Which is the least number to be subtracted?
990, sir. This is right in our classwork, sir.
10 is to be subtracted.
Yes, sir. Sir, this is right in our classwork.
See, when the things are taught, you keep asking, should I write it in the notebook, will you give notes? It is simply waste of time. When we give notes, you please write and don't ask for homework. We will give. Now I have another question. The question here is, find the least number that should be added to 1000 so that 65 divides the sum exactly. In the previous question, we have done what should be subtracted. Here we have to do what should be added. Yes, we shall solve it now. How do we solve this? Should we have to divide?
Sir, 25 should be minus, sir. So that 65.
The question is what should be added, not subtracted. This is to be understood. What should be added?
Sir, 50 should be added. 50 should be added.
50 should be added. How did you get that?
1040, sir, that can be divided by 65, sir. 65 into 16 is equal to 1040, sir.
Yes, how did you get 40?
Sir, by dividing the 1000
minus 2000. The
reminder is 25,
1000, you have divided by 65.
65, sir. Then the reminder will...
You have multiplied with 2,
sir.
Here you will multiply with 1,
sir.
You will be getting.
Sir, answer is 25, sir. Answer is 40, sir.
Answer is 40, sir.
Now, what should be considered here in the quotient?
In the quotient, it will...
Hmm.
Answer is 15.3.
How many times you will multiply? Is it two times or three times?
Five times, sir.
You have to multiply 16 times of 65.
Sir, answer is
this will be 1040.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, 1040 minus 1000, which is 40,
equals to 40.
To be added.
Yes, sir. To 1000.
To 1000, so that
it will.
It is exactly divisible
by 65.
By
it is
65.
Sir.
Whenever what should be subtracted is there, we subtract the remainder. But whenever what should be added is there, we will search for the next number. Here we have 15, we will multiply with the 16. This is very important thing. Yes, somebody says there is another method. Yes.
65 minus 25, sir, is equal to 40, sir.
65
minus 25
minus 25
equals to 40.
Is equal to 40. 40. Explain,
it is another method. Add 2000, sir.
This is 40
should be added.
Then it will be 1000 subtract remainder from divisor.
Here, very important thing is when any question is given, this will work. This will work. You keep dividing, you get some quotient. The next number after the quotient, successor of the quotient, you multiply with the divisor. We get some number. From that number, you subtract the given 1000. We get exactly. If you have not understood this, I'll give another example. What should be added to 12? So that it is exactly divisible by 5. Vinny?
3.
3 should be added.
3, sir.
Because 15 divided by 3, sorry, divided by 5 is 3. So when you divide this 2 times, it will be 10. 2 will remain. Here, some quotient is there. Next number you take, it is 5 times of 3. Which is 15. Okay. Now you subtract 15 minus 10. Sorry, 15 minus 12. So
three
is the number which must be added. In another shortcut method, it is 5 minus 2, which is 3. So 3 to be added. Sir. This 5 is the divisor, 2 is the remainder. Divisor
reminder.
Reminder if you give, you will get the same result.
Yes, sir.
Hope it is clear now.
Yes, sir.
I'll give only this question for you to solve.
Yes, sir.
Can you remember which one divided by 15? Give 7. Sir.
So someone is presenting.
Where is your screen, sir? In this 7 is question.
8.
Yes. Find the number which when divided by 15 gives 7 as quotient and 3 as a remainder.
Sir, 108. Answer is 108.
Answer is 108. Yes.
Dividend equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder.
Sir, answer is 108, sir.
Plus remainder, sir.
Dividend.
108, sir, answer.
Is equal to
108.
Divisor
into. Sir, answer is
into
108.
Quotient plus reminder.
Into quotient plus reminder. Plus reminder.
Yes,
screen plus remember,
sir. See screen?
Yes, sir.
Sir, answer is 108, sir.
Screen is not visible to Prithvi.
Sir, visible, sir.
Prithvi, you have visible, some network issue.
Sir, answer.
The same thing you have learned as Bhajya, Bhajaka, Bhagalabdha, Shesha, something, right? We have to use the same thing here.
Sir,
15 find a number which when divided by 15, it means that divisor is 15.
15.
Give 7 as a quotient. Quotient is 7 plus remainder is 3. Is this correct?
7, 105. Yes, sir.
15 into 7 is 105. 105 added to 3 is 105. Hope this is clear to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, network is full, sir. Screen not enabled, sir.
See, the problem is if I do this as a full screen, the writing will not be that clear. If I am writing it is 15 into 7, sometimes we will not get, there will be an overlap of the lines. So I felt that this way of writing is better.
Okay, sir.
If you want, I can just increase the size like this.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay, sir. Look at this. Look at this. We have to do addition. Very important thing is we have to write the numbers in a proper order. Then only the things will become easy to write. Here,
sir.
In the ones place, I have to write 9. Here 6. Here 4.
4.
7.
7.
0.
0.
5 3 7 0 0 0 1 4 6 6. Now to do addition, I have to add the respective columns. 9 plus 7 is 16. 16. 1 will be carry here.
7.
1 and 6 is 7.
1,48,476.
1,48,476. Somebody says screen is not visible. Who is that? Is the screen not visible?
Sir, screen is visible.
Sir, it is visible, sir. It is visible, sir.
Why it is visible?
It is visible, sir.
Sir,
it is clearly visible, sir.
It is clearly visible. If
yes,
there is a problem, yes, you please check it.
Sir, why is it not clear, sir?
Yes, sir. Because the time is up, sir. When the time is completed, the voice will not be that clear. Now it's sir, time up.
Sir, what's the homework, sir?
I will give
sir,
notes.
Sir, what's the homework, sir?
There are few more questions.
Notes will be sent, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, please send the homework in group.
So I shall end today's class here. I'll give the notes for today's class followed by 2-3 questions. That's the work for today. Thank you.